Hello everyone, my name is Arvind Panda. I am a fourth year student from UPS Dehradun. I am a legal intern in Lexis & Company for the month of June. Today, I am going to speak on the topic gender discrimination. So let us first understand what actually is gender discrimination. So when a person or a group of people are discriminated or not given equal opportunity just because they belong to a certain gender, then it is considered as gender discrimination. In India, it is not a very newly concept which is being introduced. It has a very vast history. From earlier times, it is considered that men are born to earn bread for their families, whereas women are born to take care of their household. Comparatively, women are considered weak. So they are being treated like to take care of their household. Women in India are discriminated on various fields like education, job, health, etc. In India, inequality predicts on gender is a habitual civil right. Misdeed that takes in a multiple shapes, including sexual harassment, unequal remuneration for women who do the equal jobs as men, and inequality even at the stage of pregnancy. Though the Indian Constitution provides and privileges for men and women and make equal provisions to improve the status of women in society, majority of women are still unable to enjoy the rights and opportunities granted to them. Despite the fact that Indian Constitution gave one and the same rights and benefits to men and women and makes parallel pronouncement to enhance the status of ladies in the social community. The rights and opportunities ensured to the women by the Constitution are still far away to enjoy the benefit by maximum part of women. The anti-female attitude and inequality in the society compel the women population to bring down in the traditional value system, like too much household responsibility diminish their opportunity to flourish. In the recent era, few other factors like lowest literacy rate, unemployment, poverty, amongst women are very common in India because of gender disparity in society. So now let us understand the environmental factor which are responsible for gender discrimination. At work, this disparity is visible through a different working environment for women. Unequal wages, undignified treatment, sexual harassment, higher working hours, engagement in harmful industries, occupational hazard, working roughly twice as many hours as men, and nearly 27% of women are accounted by unpaid activities. Violence against women is also prominent in India, which lead to every 42 minutes a sexual harassment occurring in our country. So let us understand the inequality in education. A primary outcome of this increased focus on education and learning has been a sizable increase in literacy rate among the Indian population, from approximately 18% to 65% in the fifth year ending in 2001. However, a significant gender gap is nearly 22% still remained at the beginning of 21st century. So let us understand the factor behind growing gender inequality. There are various factors for growing this inequality and discrimination, but the main we are going to discuss are such as economic factor, labor participation. This is wage inequality between men and women in India. A substantial number of women enter the labor market after 30s, generally after completion of their reproductive roles of childbearing and rearing. Access to credit. So there are large dispensaries between men and women in terms of access of banking service. Women often lack collateral for bank loans due to low level of poverty, ownership, and microcredit scheme have come under security for coercive lending practices. So occupational inequality. Women are not allowed to have combat roles in military service. Permanent commission could not be granted to female officer because they have neither been trained or command nor have been the responsibility in India. Property rights. although women have equal rights under the law to own property and receive equal inheritance rights, yet in practice women are at a disadvantage. The Hindu Succession Act of 2005 provide equal inheritance right to ancestral and jointly owned property. The law is weakly enforced. Women inequality in proper inheritance. Women are insignificantly deprived of their proper inheritance, cultural and religiously, as well. The religious constitution doesn't give women equal inheritance. There is segregation of giving the property to women, as they will not be given the property as men can have. Though Islamic constitution permit women having at least half of the property as men, society is reluctant to give the designed property to women, let alone give the equal share. There are also various inequality for women, such as employment inequality, also inequality in their health and etc. However, government are introducing various other plans for the equal treatment.